But they were so nice, they didn't want me to feel bad. But I did feel bad. I had wasted 2 automobile tows and a car battery and all their time. So I went to pick up the Batmobile all refreshed and fixed, and I took a box of donuts. And I walked into that store with my head hung low, and I said, I am so sorry for wasting your time. I will pay more attention. And I gave them a box of donuts. They said, it's no problem, Mr. Holmes, whatsoever, no problem. And so I drove the Batmobile home with full confidence now that I just needed to pay more attention. And Will, my little son, he's so cute because he's going through the whole thing with me. He's like, I believe in you, Dad. I'll help you remember to turn off the car. We get by with a little help from our friends. So listen, honestly, God, 6 days later, I was at a coffee shop, and I walked out of the coffee shop after being in there for about an hour and a half, and the Batmobile wouldn't start again. But I do honestly remember that the last thing I did before I got out to go in the coffee shop was play with some of the buttons, because there's so many cool electronics in the Batmobile, which is why we named it the Batmobile. And I was like, what is the matter with me? And that is a hard phone call to make to Infiniti, because they already wrote all this stuff down about me, right? Doesn't matter that I brought them donuts. Somewhere in their file it says, careful, idiot. So I call him up and I go, I don't know what to say, but the car didn't start again. I mean, he told me I didn't turn it off. I think I turned it off, but I'm not sure I turned it off. Anyway, we helped him fix the problem. They said, no problem, Mr. Combs. And they sent another tow truck, and they brought the car in, and they said, and then Adam's becoming my friend in the service department, right? And I said, Adam, look, I know I'm not turning off the car, but on one hand, I might be turning off the car. He's like, listen, I'm going to do a real thorough check of this. You brought this in 3 times, so he does a real thorough check. He calls me a couple days later, and he goes, you're not turning off the car. And then he says, this is one of my favorite all-time lines I've ever heard of out of a grown man's mouth. He said, did we train you to turn off the car when you bought it, Mr. Combs? I said, well, Adam, as a matter of fact, you didn't. Now, I just presumed you didn't train me to turn off the car because I had been driving an Infiniti for 8 years, and it was the same button, and I successfully turned off the other car for 8 years. He goes, well, listen, it's on us. It's our responsibility. We probably should have trained you to turn off the car. So when you come in to pick up the car, we'll just train you to turn off the car. I said, I am not going to miss this. So I drove down there. This time I'm in a good mood. And a grown man says, come on, Mr. Combs, I'll show you how to do it. I said, I can't wait. And we sit down in the Batmobile. God, I wish you could have been there. Because the grown man turns to me and he goes, all right, Mr. Combs, this is how you do it. You see that button right there that says on, off? Yeah. It's all right. You press it like that. I said, could you do that for me again, please?